rise, my soul. Remember this, He took my sin, He buried it. No longer I who live, now Jesus lives in me. For I was dead in sin, but I woke up to see the light. No, I won't boast, but in the cross that saved my soul, all else is lost. The grip of fear has no hold on me. So where, oh death, where is your sting? No longer I who live, now Jesus lives in me. For I was dead in sin, but I woke up to see the light. All of this for your glory. Oh, all of this for your glory. Oh, all of this for your glory. Oh, all of this for your glory.
Kids, for those of you who are born on the month of February, I just want to say happy birthday. Rawr!
Hey kids, it's Pastor Gio here. Have you ever been denied or rejected by your friends or family when you're trying to help or you're trying to be nice to them? Well, I have, and it doesn't feel good. One day, I saw one of my friends. He was struggling with his homework, mathematics to be exact. Now, I wasn't great at math. I was just okay. And when I saw my friend stressing out with his homework, I told him that I can help him without giving him the answers. He said, sure. And so I helped him out. But before we could finish, he was like, get away, Gio, just leave me alone. And I was like, what? So I went away feeling sad and hurt. You know, so in today's video, we're gonna check it out, what it means to follow Jesus.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story. Inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 4, verses 14. Through 30.
Even though Jesus was on this earth for 33 years, there's still not much we know about his first 30 years. We do know that he visited Jerusalem for the Passover feast with his parents. He learned carpentry skills from his father, Joseph. And when he was about 30, he went down to the Jordan River and asked his cousin, John, to baptize him in the water.
It is right for us to do this. It carries out God's holy plan.
As Jesus rose from the water, God's voice called out from heaven.
This is my son, and I love him. I am very pleased with him.
It was an incredible way for Jesus to begin his ministry. After 40 days in the wilderness alone with God, Jesus returned to Galilee, filled with the Spirit of God. Anytime he visited a new town, he went to the place of worship, the synagogue, to teach the people.
You are the light of the world.
Isn't he just the bee's knees?
Everywhere Jesus went, people were amazed and praised his teaching. That is, until he got to Nazareth, the town where he had grown up.
Well, if it isn't Carpenter Boy Jesus!
Hey man, where you been?
We hear you talk real big now.
On the Sabbath day, Jesus went into the synagogue. An attendant handed him a rolled papyrus.
The scroll of Isaiah.
Isaiah was a prophet who lived hundreds of years before Jesus, and God had spoken to Isaiah about a Messiah who had come to rescue God's people, and Isaiah had written down every word.
Watch that papyrus as you unroll it. A bit crackly.
Jesus stood before the crowd of worshipers and unrolled the scroll until he came to the right place.
The Spirit of the Lord is on me. He has anointed me to announce the good news to poor people. He has sent me to announce freedom for prisoners. He has sent me so that the blind will see again. He wants me to set free those who are treated badly. And he has sent me to announce the year when he will set his people free.
There was silence as Jesus rolled up the scroll and sat back down. Everyone stared.
Today, this passage of scripture is coming true as you listen.
Jesus hadn't just read some dry, dusty, ancient words. Jesus had declared that he was God's Messiah, that he was there to announce good news and bring freedom to the poor, the hurting, and those who had been mistreated.
Well, he's Joseph's son, isn't he? He can't be the Messiah.
What I'm about to tell you is true. A prophet is not accepted in his hometown.
Words are easy.
He calls himself a prophet? I studied with him on those benches right over there.
Thinks he's something special because he can read a scroll.
All around the synagogue, people rose to their feet, glaring. They turned on Jesus.
You are not welcome here anymore.
That's right.
We don't need you making things up.
The people were so angry they forced Jesus out of the synagogue. He allowed them to herd him straight through the village, all the way to a cliff on the edge of town.
Get rid of him!
Throw him down!
But Jesus simply turned and looked at the people, sorrow in his eyes. The men and women that he'd known and loved growing up wouldn't accept who he was. The crowd couldn't face Jesus. In their anger, they had missed the whole point that Jesus had come to make things right for those who were hurting and overlooked. Jesus walked right through the crowd, away from the cliff edge. They parted to let him go through. Then he left Nazareth and went on to Capernaum, where he continued to carry out his mission.
Wow. Even the people that Jesus loved and served was giving Jesus a hard time. And yet, it doesn't change Jesus' heart to love them and serve them. Instead of being bitter and hurt, Jesus showed compassion. Jesus knew his purpose, to love and serve others. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, that you love us so much, Father, that you never gave up on us. Help us to teach us your way. Help us to have more compassion to others. In Jesus' mighty name, everyone say, amen. Thank you for spending your Sunday with us. Remember, we have our daily contents on Mondays through Fridays and, of course, Sundays. We'll see you in our Zoom classes later this afternoon. Bye. Thank you.